I do want to say that we try to do the story legally.
There it is. A little town with a really big secret. It's so bizarre. What's going on over here?
Muchas secuencias de los documentales de Luis Zoeus parecen películas de espionaje, pero sus personajes no son agentes imaginados por un guionista. Son ambientalistas que han tomado acción para develar la situación del deterioro que enfrenta el planeta.
OPS is a group I formed. It uses covert operations to expose harmed endangered species.
We're doing an order here.
One bottle cam.
Right there's the lens.
Two buttonhole cameras.
Check 1, 2.
Oh, that's good.
Después de trabajar la mayor parte de su carrera como fotógrafo, Zoeus descubrió en los documentales un poder de persuasión que no había tenido con las imágenes fijas.
Well, you know, I was a still photographer for, I don't know, 35 years before I started making a film. And I thought I had the best job in the world. I worked at National Geographic magazine. You know, it was one of the most coveted photographic positions in the world. But then when I made a film, you see people laughing, crying, cheering, and then asking what they can do to help afterwards. And that I never had that personally with photographs.
Zoeus, con su primer documental, The Cove, ganó el Oscar en el 2009. En este escondió cámaras dentro de dispositivos hollywoodenses y enlistó abusos profesionales para grabar y tener pruebas de la matanza de delfines cerca a Taiji, Japón.
I'd never seen so many dolphins before.
Sus películas están plagadas de cámaras ocultas e imágenes de visión nocturna que dan un tono de misterio y muestran el peligro que corren los ambientalistas en su empeño por descubrir la explotación de distintas especies.
Rolling Stone magazine said that The Cove is a cross between The Bourne Identity and Flipper. I think it's a, you know, but the films I make are, it's a result of watching too many Jacques Cousteau specials and James Bond movies. If you look at the films, you know, there's a lot of gadgets, there's a lot of people with special skills. It's almost like an Ocean's 11 film or The Avengers. So it feels like a thriller, you know, it's an eco-thriller. It doesn't feel like a traditional documentary, and I think that's probably why they appeal to a younger audience. The structure came up after we were almost done. We had some making, we were thinking, there was so many times we were in the hotel rooms trying to figure out how to sneak past the police and the guards. We thought that'd be a cool movie, maybe a DVD extra. And then when we got back to the studio and started making things up, maybe we used some of that footage. Then we sort of stumbled on this sort of thriller theme. And we did the same thing with Racing Extinction. You can tell a story without, you know, let's say putting ourselves into it, but it wouldn't be as interesting. I think people, they like that narrative structure. They want to be carried away on a story. You know, most documentaries, they just tell the subject, and it can be sort of dry. It feels like you're taking college level course, I went to school, I went to college, I went to several colleges, but you know, if you're just hearing a lecture, it gets a little bit dull. After about 45 minutes, you know, the seat gets, your butt gets tired. You want to, you know, but if you get swept away in a story, you know, it's like you go to the gymnasium. If you're just lifting weights, you know, you think, oh, this, it gets boring, you know, or in a treadmill. But if you're doing a sport where you're, you know, chasing a ball, it's a team sport, you're playing soccer, then you're getting an exercise because your brain's thinking. It's concentrating while your body's getting a workout, and it's a little bit like that.
Pero el verdadero protagonista de las películas de Luis Zoeus no es él ni su equipo de expertos. Es el planeta Tierra y las criaturas que habitan en él. Por esto aprovecha cuando va por todo el mundo presentando sus documentales para exponer su punto de vista, con el que cree se puede ayudar a conservar y vivir en armonía con la naturaleza.
About 8 years now. I don't pay for gasoline. You know, the burning of fossil fuels is acidifying the oceans. So anything you can do to minimize your carbon production is really important. The single most important thing people can do is to get on a plant-based diet. A vegan driving a Hummer uses less energy than a meat eater driving a bicycle. So if you want to change the world, change your diet slightly, adopt more of a plant-based diet.
They're not being told that the free lunch meat that their children are getting are contaminated.
Let it not be said that you didn't know about it.
You know about it.
Well, I think the biggest issue is that people, you know, everybody says, I'm just one person, what can I do? You know, and the thing is, one person can do a lot. The anthropologist Margaret Mead said, never doubt that a small group of people can change the world. It's the only thing that ever has.